In this video, we will show you how to set up data for futures to achieve the same results directly in the TradeStation platform. This setting is very important, so please do not skip this video. First, let's explain some important information. Sessions or trading sessions in TradeStation determine the time frame in which the platform will display and analyze price data in a specific market, such as stock index futures, crude oil or gold. Thanks to sessions, we can adjust the displayed time periods according to our needs. For example, display only main trading hours or vice versa, see all trades taking place outside of the main hours, the so-called regular session. In the real world, futures markets often run 24 hours a day, but with one main trading session, for example from 8:30 a.m. to 3:15 p.m. on a particular exchange for stock indexes. That's why TradeStation allows you to distinguish which part of the day you want to see on your chart, so you can better analyze given price movements. From experience, displaying only a specific session can improve the performance of strategies, but you also need to know how to set it up correctly to do so. To trade future strategies, we need the entire history of data. It is called continuous contract. In reality, however, this contract is always made up of a large number of smaller contracts that are kind of combined together. There are different methods of combining, which results in differences in futures data. Well, and some brokers disclose the methods, but some don't. And this then makes it difficult for us to achieve the same backtest results directly in the platform. But now, let's show everything in practice. We have TradeStation running. And to display a new chart, we click on File, New and Chart Analysis. To view the session, right-click and click Format Symbol. Here we set a specific time frame, and in Properties, we can see which session we are currently using. And when I click on this three-dot button, I see that we are using the so-called regular session. This means that we are using all the data and the session is not limited in any way. If we wanted to display the given session, as we mentioned a moment ago, we would click on US Index Futures according to the NYSE trading exchange and click OK. When I then confirm it, you can see that the time periods are recalculated for us. So, when I display both graphs side by side, we see that the specific graphs are different. It should be noted that this session setting is only supported for TradeStation or multi-charts engines for such an introduction directly to sessions. And as we can see, this setting directly affects the quality of the backtest. If we do not set this setting correctly, we will not even receive correct results directly in the TradeStation trading platform. So let's show how to first set up the data and session for the data that is available directly in StrategyQuant. Go to StrategyQuant and click on the Data Manager tab. To download data, for example, for a NASDAQ or S&P symbol, just enter the ticker name. It has to be noted that this mentioned ticker name may be different for each broker. So, what you should do, what I always recommend, is checking with your broker what your broker is using, or you can also use full text search. It's up to you. In our case, in this case, I will use ES and, for example, NQ. Now just click. And here I see that StrategyQuant found us more symbols. What I can do, I can mark them all at once. Now, the first symbol, the at sign ES, means that we are using 1 minute data and the entire session is used. The second symbol, the at sign ES.D, means that this is daily data. Now, if you're going to build intraday strategies, you need to choose the at sign ES. If you are going to build daily strategies, you will need to use the ES.D. In this case, I will choose settings for the entire session and 1 minute data. When we go to the next setting, we see that we can choose the candlestick format. If you are building strategies for TradeStation, you must choose this format, otherwise the backtest will not work for you. It is because TradeStation uses a different candlestick format than MetaTrader. To avoid any complications with changing the time zone, I recommend using the time zone of the given exchange. This is because if you use the time zone of the given exchange, you will not be confused when converting individual time zones. And of course, the same applies to TradeStation. In TradeStation, you can display the time zone according to the local time of the computer. And in this case, you must have the same time zone set in the TradeStation chart as well. I go back to StrategyQuant and add these tickers to StrategyQuant. I select to agree to the terms and conditions to download the data. And I already downloaded the data before. That's why they are here in duplicate with the number 2 at the end. Now to download this data, I selected the tickers, then clicked on update selected button. And now we just have to wait for a moment for the data to be downloaded. My data has been downloaded, and to achieve the same result in StrategyQuant and also in TradeStation, I need to set the correct session in the builder settings. I go to builder and I click that I want default settings for TradeStation. The settings have been loaded and we will go to full settings and then trading options tab. Now let's go through the individual settings for TradeStation. We are using the exit on Friday here, and what is important is that for TradeStation Engine, it is also necessary to set the maximum distance in percentage. This is due to the limitations of the given platform, because if we were to enter a pending order further than the aforementioned 6%, our order would be rejected. Therefore, it is a good idea to set this value and also limit this setting. Then, here is the important session setting. As I said, we use regular session. If we were using a limited session, for example, from 8:30 a.m. to 3:15 p.m., we would just select US index futures here. Next, we also need to set the reserved bars just for TradeStation, and we need to set this value the same way we have set the value of the indicators. Here I see that I'm using an indicator period of 14 to 400, so I set 500 here. And that's it for this setup. If we can find session and we want to add a custom one, we go into the data manager and add the session. For the sake of illustration, let's show how to set up a session with TradeStation. Ideally, let's use the windows side by side and adjust the settings according to what we see on screen. Please just give me a second. I'm just going to get this a little bit more organized and then we'll take a look at that. So we start at 8:30 on Monday. So we set up Monday 8:30. And end at 3:10 p.m. We set the session to end at the end of the day. And now we can simply copy that. And that's how we have the session set up. Of course, we can save the session to a specific broker profile. I'm going to use SQ default and I'm going to mark the NYSE US index, for example. I look up the session and I see that when I click back, I have the session set up exactly as I need it. So I would now go back into the builder and set the NYSE. So that's it for the session setup. I hope it's clear now how to set up the session, and in the last step, we will show you how to import data directly from TradeStation. So let's switch over to TradeStation and let's show how to export the data into StrategyQuant. We can export data in two ways. Either we export the minute data and set the session directly in StrategyQuant, or we export the data directly with a given session and for the given time frame, and we do not set the session further in StrategyQuant. I will show you both ways. First, I will show how to set the data directly with a given session. Let's say we are going to use a regular session here in this case, and in case we were using a different session, so we will set up a specific session for a given time frame here. We have a 60 minute or hourly time frame, time zone, exchange, and we are exporting the data from the 1st of January 2024. If you wanted to export data for the entire time period, here you would set the range from to when you want to export the data. In the case where we would export 1 minute data, we would again set the first date, set the 1 minute candles, and again time zone is exchange. When you export 1 minute data, you would leave the whole session in there, that is the regular session. Now click on OK and the data is downloaded. We can see that we have the last year of data history here. Now let's see the data window. Here we can browse the data and then save it. And I'm going to save it to my desktop. Let's see how to import the data into StrategyQuant now. Let's switch to the Data Manager tab. And first thing we need to do is to create a symbol. So click on File, Import, and I'm going to mark this symbol with, for example, the ES underscore TS. We select the bar format. In this case, we'll select TradeStation because this bar format is different from MetaTrader, and we select the symbol. If we do not have the symbol here, we can add it manually. We will select the default broker profile, ESTS. We select futures, set tick size. We can find it directly on the exchange or broker's website. And here I set a 0.25 tick step and set a default spread of 2 ticks. Just be careful here. We do show pips, but it means the same thing. It's just different terminology within futures or Forex. We can set the default slippage here, but in this case, I'm going to leave it at 0, and then I can set it according to the market. We also set commissions here. In this case, I will set, for example, $8, but you always need to check with your broker. Now we have the instrument set up. We click on save. And this instrument will be set up right away. If we already have this instrument in the menu, like for example I have here, we can just select it like it is. I'm going to set up the one we set up manually and click on save. The symbol will be added, and now I will import the data. I select the symbol, click on import file, then I find the file on my desktop and set the time zone. I select that it's 1 minute data and click on import. We've got the data imported, and let's recap the whole setup in Builder. So, if we are going to use the current symbol that we've set up, so we'll go into Trading Options tab again. Here, we need to remember to set the maximum distance. If we are also using the Friday exit, we need to take into account the time of the exchange. And importantly, set the session correctly. In this case, when we use minute data, StrategyQuant will automatically convert the 1 minute data to a higher time frame and use the regular session. In the case that we use a given time frame with a specific session, the session will not be used here because we already have the session set directly in the data. So I'm going to switch it back to regular session here and enter 500 reserve bars. As I explained a moment ago, this value needs to correspond with the value of the indicators. By having 14 to 400 here, I recommend putting some small margin in there so that StrategyQuant will use the 500 reserved bars value. And the calculation of the indicators will be done reliably then. If we look further into the data settings, here we have a symbol that we set up, time frame, period from to, and because TradeStation only has a selected time frame, so we will use that value. We have the default here, the spread is calculated in ticks, but watch out with the slippage there, because it has to be set in dollars. So, what you have to do is to calculate the value of one tick and set this value according to how many ticks we want to use for a slippage. In short, we convert the value of ticks to dollars and set this value. For example, we can set the slippage here to $25 for 2 ticks. And that would be it for setting up and importing data. I hope everything was clear, and if you have any questions, please let us know in the comments, and I will look forward to seeing you in the next video.